Hi everyone, I'm Aurélie, the director of Andrew Edlin Gallery, and I'm joined here with Karla Knight for her second solo exhibition with the gallery, Roadtrip, on view through July 1st. Now Karla, we have a few questions for you.
Yes.
First question, tell me a little bit about the title of the exhibition and what it means to you.
Well, my work tends to be about journeys. When you look at the work, there's a lot of vehicles, there are wheels, there's spaceships, there's different modes of travel. And, you know, when I think of a road trip, I think of a trip where you don't necessarily know the destination, where it's unknown, and you're on the road, and you're finding your way, which is, I think, a lot of what my work is about, being the unknown.
Mm-hmm.
And so it seemed really right for the show.
Between the New York Times profile earlier this year,
yeah,
and your wow, incredible, you know, recognition that you received for the Aldrich Museum show, what do you make of the heightened attention at this time in your long career, and what does it mean to you?
I see it, I think, in terms of the rest of my work, it's unknown. And so I try not to judge or predict or presume why this has come to me now. I'm just grateful for it. The Aldrich was a dream come true for any artist would have died for that. It was a 40-year survey. I got to show work from years ago and really see the progression of my language and imagery evolving over all those years. Amy Smith Stewart was the curator, and she gave me free rein to explore a whole new body of work, the tapestries. I just started making them when I was offered the show at the museum. So I knew the space I had, all the big walls I was going to have to fill, and I just ran with the tapestries. The work in this show, Roadtrip, has developed out of the work from Navigator at the Aldrich. You see it progressing, and it's mutated and grown. So, and the wheels and the kind of mandala images in the new tapestries. Really, you can see the roots of them in the Aldrich tapestries. I've been thinking about mandalas a lot, and wheels again. It's another trip, travel,
right.
Of course, mandalas are spiritual, you know, centerings and. That's always on my mind.
And the waves also.
There are waves, yep. There are waves occasionally in some of the paintings and in the tapestries too. So I've been thinking a little bit about water and ships. And I mean, my last show here was called Notes from the Lightship. So obviously, I'm always thinking about vehicles to go places.
Right.
Literal and figurative. So I've been looking at the winter counts for years. I mean, I used to live in the Southwest in New Mexico. They're basically calendars of the Lakota lives, and with pictographs done often in spirals, with a pictograph for every year and some major event that the a death or a war or a harvest or a celestial event or something, and the Lakota would make pictographs of them, and on this kind of muslin fabric, painted and drawn lightly with watercolor. And they're just gorgeous. They're just gorgeous. So I've been thinking for years, how do I make something like that? What fabric would I use? How would I paint what I use? You know, I mean, it was a matter of technique. And I came upon these, I don't even remember how, but I came upon these feed bags, seamless feed bags from the Midwest that farmers used to send grain and seeds and rice. And I found those on eBay and started buying them up. They're beautiful, kind of, again, that cream color that I love. And they have these nice ticking lines of different colors running through them. So I fell in love with that fabric. It also has an age to it that the ledger paper does as well. So it's repurposed old stuff that I like. So I started sewing them together, and then I went with a the sewing machine, and uh-huh. I had this field of like a cottony muslin type big field of fabric, and then I just started going nuts with my imagery and language on it. So that was how the tapestry started. And it really came out of a desire to make something like Winter Counts. And once I found the fabric, I was off to the races with the tapestry.
Right. And it's interesting too, how long have you been using electric paper now?
You know, since the mid-80s.
Wow.
A long time, almost 40 years.
Wow.
I've always loved electric paper, and I have, you know, stacks, you've been in my studio, stacks of old ledger books that I also buy from eBay.
Right.
I love the little numbers and the different kind of formats of them, and the books, I love books. It's more of a literary bent that I have that, mm-hmm. you know, and I love paper, I love to draw, and it just has an age to it that I love. And so yeah, I've been doing it for years.
And, you know, we should stress also, so the paintings, right, it's ledger paper that you collage on.
Yes, this painting here, it's on linen, but it, on top of all the linen, it's got ledger paper all over.
So you're really using it.
So yeah, so yeah. Basically what I like to do is make a huge drawing and then start painting on it.
Mm-hmm.
So I can basically do my drawing things and my painting things and do all the things that I like to do. And then I add these typed poems in here, which is in a lot of the work in Roadtrip. And again, that's another part of me wanting to let all the sides of myself live. And part of me likes to write. Mm-hmm. And has always liked to write poems and poem lists. And I've spent years, like 20 years, gathering these kind of two-word phrases that I found in books, some of the science books.
Mm-hmm.
Some I made up myself. At the Navigator opening, someone said to me, these would be great names for bands. You know, if you read that, well, they would be. So I just have these lists, and I put my writing into the work.
Right.
Because why not? Why can't I write as well as...
Of course.
Yeah. I always wanted to be an artist, but writer was number two on my list.
Studies also seem to be really important.
Yes. I mean, for instance, for the tapestries, those big tapestries, I can't mm-hmm. just, you know, start them. I make studies at first to mm-hmm. figure out where I'm going to basically have things. And they do shift a bit once I get into the big work. But I do have an idea where things are going to go, main imagery.
Mm-hmm.
So I make a lot of studies, and I sit there at night and draw, you know, for hours.
And it's very developed studies too, right? Like that are featured in the exhibition and our, you know, works. And,
yeah.
And I love some of them in particular. You can kind of see some of the graphite that's been raised sometimes.
You can see me thinking. And I like to see artists, I like to watch artists think.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and often in drawings, it's the best place to see an artist think if they're going to be loose and kind of, you know, forgiving. I'm going to make more of those. They were fun.
I love those.
Yes, they're fun. You know, whatever's fun, I'm going to go with it because that always works for me.
Right.
You know, whatever turns me on is what I'm just going to keep messing with.